Hey guys, welcome to my channel. If you're new here, hi, my name is Amanda Rose, and in today's video, I am going to be showing you guys how I use the Duvel Sonic Facial Brush. It's also gonna be a review, if I like it or not, the pros and cons of this facial brush. But before we do get started, please subscribe to my channel for beauty and lifestyle. Also, don't forget to click the post notification bell just to be notified when my videos do go live. And without further ado, let's go ahead and get into it. So as you know, I have already collabed with Duvel before. They approached me again, asked me if I wanted to try anything from their website, and I said yes, I wanted to try another product because I was so happy with the spin care system that I had tried maybe about a year ago. I'm not quite sure how long it was, not even a year ago. I wanted to see how the Sonic facial brush compared to the spin care brush that I had used before. All right, so let's go ahead and get into the claims of this facial brush. There are four cleaning modes and four different speeds. There is a USB that you can just plug right into it to charge it. The vibration frequency can reach up to 6,000 to 12,000 times per minute. And then the other side of the brush has a low frequency impulse that can promote the blood circulation in the wrinkle prone area and help restore skin firmness and elasticity. It says that with the high frequency that it can remove dirt from your skin, which I can kind of see how that is. So it also says that it is made with food grade silicone. It is easy to clean, dries quickly, and will not breed bacteria. It is also waterproof. And this also retails for $95, but I do have a code for you guys. If you guys do want to go ahead and use my code for 70% off, and you will get this brush for very, very inexpensive. I think it's like $28.50 or something, $30, I can't remember. Go ahead and check that out down below. Now we're gonna go ahead and talk about how I used it, what I thought about it throughout the process of using it, and if I would recommend getting this facial brush. Now, I do love the shape of this. It is really nice. It's very easy to hold. It is grippable. So on here, you can see that there are bristles on here and they do move around just a little bit. They are a little tight on here. You do have a whole bunch of little grips here and then bigger grips here. On this side, you have to massage stuff in. And then on the bottom here, this is kind of similar to like a gua shua or a rose quartz roller ball. It is very, very cooling. You can use this under your eyes. You can use this all over your face after you put oils on. And then you have the on switch right here, and then you have the different modes. You can go up to, down to, if you want it to be slower or faster. You have the port right here to charge. We do have a charger here, so you pretty much just put it in like this and it charges. And then you do have to have a block, like a USB block, I think that's what you call it, I have no idea. A USB block to put this into to charge it, which it is really nice because with the spin care brush, you only have batteries, and I would rather not have batteries because I do typically keep these in the shower. I wash my face in the shower. I just like to get all that stuff done. Another thing that you can use this for is not only washing your face, but when you turn it over, or if you use this side, you can use it for moisturizer, you can use it for oils if you really want it to go deep into your skin. Now, as for did I like it or not, I'm kind of still on the fence. I used this for about a week and a half. This did clean my face pretty well. I wouldn't say that it cleaned my face thoroughly. As you guys had seen from the footage, even when I had put my toner on, I still had some makeup left. This is after using my cleanse off oil, using this to clean off my face with my moisturizer. There's still dirt and makeup left on my face. With the spin care brush, there was little to no makeup left on my face. So I'd probably say the only thing that I like about it is that yes, it does clean your face, and you can use this side for underneath your eyes is what I used it for. So it depuffs the eyes. This is very easy to clean, like super easy to clean. All you have to do is run this under water and everything will come off of it. I didn't have an issue with cleaning this at all. With charging it, I probably left this on the charger for a full day while I was doing housework and stuff like that. So charging, there isn't an issue with charging this. It charges up just fine. But for the cons, I would probably say that this area right here is really stiff. It didn't really suds up. When I wash my face, I like to see the suds. I like to feel the suds. I feel like it is working if I see the suds, and it just didn't do that. And like I had said before, I just felt like it didn't clean my face as well as the spin care brush. I just felt like when I was washing my face, it just looked like I had water all over my face. I can't really compare this to any other type of facial brush like this. I do have the PMD one that I will be doing a review on probably next month, and I will do a comparison between the two. But when I had felt the PMD one, the bristles were a little longer and they felt a lot softer. But we will see how that works out. I will do a review on it next month. But all in all, would I suggest getting this product? I would say that I'm kind of up in the air about it. I like it, but I don't love it. So it does work, and you can't beat the price. So if you want something that's gonna be more affordable than the PMD one, then this one is definitely the one to go with. It definitely gets the job done. But again, for me, it was just, I really like the suds and I felt like it didn't really clean as much as I wanted it to. Maybe I was doing something wrong, I have no idea, but it just wasn't my favorite. All right guys, so that is it for my video. It was really short, I know, but I like to get to the point when it comes to these kinds of things, and there's really nothing else left to say about it. So let me know if you guys have tried this facial brush or if you've tried anything like it. I'd love to have a conversation with you guys down below. Also, don't forget that I do have a discount code for you guys on any Duvol product for 70% off. That code will be down below in my description box. Also, thank you to Duvol for working with me again. It was really fun to try something else out other than what I typically go for. All right guys, so that is it for me. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. My channel. This new iOS like is not very fun. Okay, I literally have like 3 minutes. Okay, vibration frequency. Hold on. Okay. So, okay.